USS Preble, which is based out of Pearl Harbor, will be the first American destroyer to be equipped with a high-energy laser. Rear Admiral Ronald Boxall, the U.S. Navy's Director of Surface Warfare, told Defense News that USS Preble will be fitted with HELIOS by 2021. HELIOS stands for High Energy Laser and Integrated Optical-dazzler with Surveillance System. High energy lasers are being seen as a way to defend against Chinese or Russian cruise missiles, drones, swarms, and small surface crafts. As per Defense News, Boxall said, "We're making the decision to put the laser on our destroyers. It's going to start with Preble in 2021, and when we do that, that will now be her close-in weapon that we now continue to upgrade." USS Preble is an Arleigh Burke Class guided missile destroyer of the U.S. Navy. Arleigh Burke Class warships were designed as multi-mission destroyers, and it is the 38th destroyer of the class. She's named after Commodore Edward Preble, who served in the American Revolutionary War and was one of the early leaders of the U.S. Navy. It was built by Ingalls Shipbuilding and was commissioned on the 9th of November, 2002. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the implication of fitting HELIOS in USS Preble. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report have stated that the U.S. currently lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, "China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures." Viewers can go through the report from the link given in the description section below. This technically means that U.S. warships and supercarriers may be vulnerable to strikes. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5, or 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, which is 6,174 kilometers per hour. One of the operational systems is the Kinzhal, developed by Russia. According to President Putin, the missile has been deployed operationally in units in the country's southern military district. There's also concern that drone swarm technology is a growing threat. Some reports have indicated that China is actively working on drone swarm technology as a method of attacking aircraft carriers and surface ships. Small and fast-moving surface crafts deployed by Iran are also cause for concern. U.S. Navy's main offensive surface combatant consists of around 10 supercarriers, 66 Arleigh Burke-class destroyers, and 22 Ticonderoga-class cruisers. The defensive weapon consists of the following. 1. Evolved Sea Sparrow Missiles, ESSM, is the primary air defense system. It has a range of 10 nautical miles, or 19 kilometers, and speed of Mach 3.5. Arleigh Burke Class has 96-cell Mark 41 Vertical Launch System, VLS, whereas Ticonderoga Class has 122 of these. Each can be quad-packed with ESSM. 2. RIM-116 Rolling Airframe Missiles is a small, lightweight, infrared homing surface-to-air missile meant for point defense. It has a speed in excess of Mach 2 and has a range of 9 kilometers or 5.6 miles. Phalanx Close-In Weapon System is deployed for last-ditch defense against airborne threats. It uses an automated 20mm Gatling gun which is capable of firing up to 50 rounds per second. These weapons will not be enough to defend against hypersonic weapons or drone swarms. Also, they could potentially be saturated by a barrage of supersonic anti-ship missiles and ultimately fail to defend the warship. Small missile boats or fast-moving crafts laden with explosives could also be a challenge to these systems. While the threat that small boats pose to major warships has been apparent for some time, the Pentagon's Millennium Challenge 2002 exercise brought the issue to mainstream attention. In that controversial exercise, small fast boats carrying suicide payloads inflicted heavy damage on U.S. naval forces. This kind of craft lacks the range to find and successfully attack aircraft carriers or warships in the open sea, but can be deadly in certain battle spaces like the Strait of Hormuz. Iran is known to have hundreds of small boats designed to ambush large American warships. Overall, it can be said that the current crop of defensive systems available to American warships, or for that matter, any warship around the world, could be found wanting when faced with these types of weapons and tactics. And this is where Helios will come in. Viewers may note that the U.S. Navy had awarded Lockheed Martin a $150 million contract in 2018, with options worth up to $943 million for the development of high-powered laser systems. The program aims to develop two prototypes, one for land and another for destroyers. As per Lockheed Martin with the Helios system, it will help the Navy take a major step forward in its goal to field a laser weapon system aboard surface ships. The Helios effort is focused on rapidly developing and deploying a 60 kilowatt high energy laser with growth potential to 150 kilowatts. Lockheed Martin said it demonstrated that a 10 kilowatt system can defeat small airborne targets with the speed of light capability, and that a 30 kilowatt system has disabled a stationary truck target. Lasers have some very important advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit on the platform. With further development, lasers can be used to save costly defensive missiles for the most sophisticated threats. There are challenges too. The most basic is that the power source will have to be scaled up, as additional power will be required for the functioning of the lasers. It's to be noted that laser is not the only systems being developed to meet emerging threats. The Congressional Research Service said in a May report that the U.S. Navy is developing three new ship-based weapons, lasers, an electromagnetic railgun, and a gun-launched guided projectile. As per the report, these weapons could substantially improve the ability of surface ships to defend against small surface craft, unmanned aerial vehicles, and eventually anti-ship cruise missiles. The report states, any one of these new weapons, if successfully developed and deployed, might be regarded as a game changer for defending Navy surface ships against enemy missiles. The research service noted that the U.S. Navy has made substantial progress toward deploying lasers on ships. This is not the first time the American military has tested laser weapons. In 2010, the Air Force mounted and fired off a megawatt-class chemical laser from a modified Boeing 747. Things have changed since then, and instead of unstable chemical laser used for that experiment, solid-state lasers are now being used. Another test with LAWS was conducted in 2014. Laser Weapon System, or LAWS, is a directed energy weapon developed by the United States Navy. It will act as a short-range, self-defense system against drones and boats. Having a cost of less than $1 per shot, it is a very cost-effective solution. The U.S. Navy had tested a 30-kilowatt laser in 2017 aboard USS Ponce. The laser was able to shoot down a Scan Eagle unmanned aerial vehicle out of the sky. Helios is a move in the right direction and will enable the U.S. military to meet future challenges in an effective manner.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.